at the end of the day, though, like, it's just, like, crackheads doing some crazy stuff out there. But make sure to smash the subscribe bell. Let's get right into it.
Single dad Alex Calvo inherited his estranged grandmother's house in Florida after her recent passing. So he and his daughters packed their bags and moved to the home to start a new life.
Damn.
The house has been in his family for four generations and has been left mostly untouched. In fact, when they move in, the home is still full of his grandmother's belongings. Alex begins to record moments from his family's move to the new house and shares his experiences on TikTok. When they first...
Okay, if it's TikTok, they... I don't know about that, bro.
Concerned viewers soon point out to him that there is something very disturbing in the video. Alex is shocked.
Oh, look at our new house. Wow. This is cool, right? Better than an apartment. Okay. Got everybody here.
So they recently moved in?
Into the new house for the first time.
Yeah, let me just back away a little, you know?
Yeah. See how scary? It's kind of scary, actually.
Yeah.
Oh, look at all this stuff.
I mean, if you're gonna put it that way, then it's a little...
Yo. Okay. This kitchen's pretty nice. Ready?
The fact that he's recording, that's like...
Close the door.
Because normally you do not record.
When Alex walks past a mirror, a creepy dark figure can be seen in the reflection.
Damn.
Alex says that he has no idea what this could have been, but he decides to keep recording his experiences in the new house. A little over a month later, and in the middle of the night, this happens.
Okay, I just heard a loud bang out here. It's the middle of the night. Sounded like it was coming from the kitchen.
Yo, can a brother perhaps know the time?
Hello?
Oh, damn. Oh, damn. Yo, that sound effect he added? Why?
Is there somebody here? Is there somebody in here?
Nah, this one, I call it cab.
What the f***?
Alex hears a loud bang and goes to investigate when a chair suddenly just moves on its own.
Hello? Oh,
yeah, he added sound effect for entertainment, I get that. 2 weeks later,
he films another chilling experience.
So I just captured something else on tape. While I was actually taking the tape, I did not notice it at all, but you go ahead and take a look at it and tell me what you
think. The face he's making.
Okay, I just heard a really loud noise coming up here from the same place where all the other stuff has been going on. Like something was dragging across the floor. Turn on the lights, like everybody says. Okay, come on. I know I heard something.
If it was really true, you wouldn't be in this house. You would just scurry, you know? Oh, damn. Oh, yo. Oh my god, you.
Turn on this light down here.
Alex doesn't notice it at the time, but he accidentally records what seems to be a pale face staring at him from a doorway.
I don't know, man. They have a policy.
Whatever's making this.
Listen, bro. Listen. They have a policy of not showing up on camera. I'm loving these videos. Don't get me wrong, but damn, you know what I mean?
Strange noises and appearing in his videos might actually be the spirit of his deceased grandmother.
This looks like a guy.
And Alex captures something absolutely terrifying.
My god, dude.
Okay, I am up here where all the different, like, scary activities happened, and I'm hearing what sounds like somebody walk around on the floorboards. As I'm up here, I can feel, like, the pressure of steps landing around me. I don't really know what's going on. It just seems pretty crazy to me. I don't know. This is not what I signed up for when I got this house.
I don't know if I wanna. Oh god, damn! I'm pretty sure they hired actors for this one.
Actually, my fucking grandmother. Oh my god! Holy shit!
Yo, we're just in the beginning. There's more stuff. No way, bro.
Your robe is sitting there on the floor. Are you kidding me?
I don't like this.
Alex can't believe
I don't like this.
Someone appears to be standing in his doorway. By the time he manages to collect himself, whoever or whatever it was has disappeared. So could it be that Alex's home is haunted by his grandmother? And if not, then just what is this? I highly recommend that you watch Alex's full story over on his TikTok page. Alex Calvo is haunted.
It's TikTok. I mean, perspective. Listen, man, I'm not like going at the homie or anything like that, but it's a little bit, you know what I mean? Might be a paid actor or something.
Her bunny toes says that she was home completely all alone with just her grandchild when she gave the baby her old phone to play with. The child accidentally starts recording a video and captures something chilling.
Let's change your butt. You smell like you poopy.
I mean, if it's a child getting scared of something, nah, you could trick a child to be scared. I don't know, it's kind of hard. It's really hard.
Reddit user Bunny Toes is shocked when she looks back at the footage. Her grandchild seems to have recorded a tall, shadow-like figure standing right behind them. The astonished Reddit user believes the apparition to possibly be her husband's deceased grandmother, who passed away 6 years ago on the exact same spot where the figure can be seen in the video. But is it a shadow figure or just a very strange trick of the light? Let me know down in the comments.
Yo. Okay, this
one. See a video that you think would be perfect for the
I don't know, dude. It's very hard to
contact me at nukes.5 at
because it can be easily faked, you know? Could be easily faked.
Hernandez Alvarez. Now, the name Abiud Hernandez Alvarez might sound familiar to you because over the last year and a half, I've featured his continuing frightening story. Abiud lives alone in an apartment in Mexico City and claims that he suddenly began to experience terrifying paranormal activity at all hours. Objects would move on their own, doors slam shut, and the sound of high heels and knocking were heard in the halls. Most horrifying of all, a strange female entity began to appear in mirrors around his house, and then the apparition even physically attacked Abiud.
Oh,
in his last video posted to Facebook, he recorded a shocking encounter with the female spirit he calls.
I was looking at my OBS and I just saw that. Oh, damn,
he
bro.
Just sort of disappeared for a while. Abiud has since returned and adopted a cute little puppy named Milo. It's not long before Milo starts to regularly react nervously to something that Abiud can't see. One night when Abiud is fast asleep in bed, a static camera records something very strange.
If a dog reacts, if an animal reacts differently. Yeah, you know what I mean, right? Like, it's... Now, personally, I believe in stuff like that, but more than half of these videos, 99% of these videos are not true, but whenever animal reacts, it's a little bit suspect, right? Most of the time, it's just crackhead energy. You never know, right? You could have tricked your dog.
Milo barks at something that we can't see, and an ominous noise can be heard that seems to respond back to the little dog. It's almost as if little Milo is trying to protect his owner from something. Over time, Milo seems to
maybe the dog owner
that we
trained him to react that way. You never
before.
Know.
The teddy bear named Googie often seems to just move on its own.
Oh my god. Milo has been playing with Googie for a long time, and he seems to be having fun with him. Yo, that's a really good dog, bro. That's a really good dog.
One day after frantically searching, Abiud can't seem to find the teddy bear anywhere. It's like it simply disappeared into thin air.
Googie has disappeared, I don't know, and I'm seeing that there on the mirror, there is water as if it's coming out of it, and all that water is draining and it's dripping onto the floor. Even on the side, you can also see how the water is draining, like from the chair, or I don't really understand, I don't know what is happening. I really don't know how to explain. That Gagi has disappeared? Well, I don't even know. Oh my god. Yeah, I heard something.
Did you see it? Even though Abiud shows an empty chair,
every time he says, did you see it?
Can be seen sitting in the chair in the mirror's reflection. Even stranger, water appears to be seeping right from the mirror itself. Eventually, teddy bear Googie returns to its usual spot and all seems to be going well. Until One night.
Okay,
Abiud hears a very loud noise coming from the same room. He once again takes out his phone and starts to record. It did not go well.
Oh my god. Yo, damn, that's gonna be scary. Oh my god. It's crackhead energy. It is crackhead. It's not real. It's not real. It's not real. Precisely where Googie's. It's not real. It's not real. It's not real.
How is possible?
Yeah, homie, just chillin'.
Okay, este aparato. Encima de Googie para que no lo movieran de lugar y bueno.
But well,
pues,
it has worked.
Hasta el momento,
so far, it has worked. Yo, why is the water? But what if he put the water? You know what I mean, right? Like, you can easily put water.
Sí.
I don't know. You can see. Okay, I'm trying. I'm trying to not look because I have a feeling. Okay, in fact, I think it's not. This has happened.
Damn,
oh shit! Oh damn! Oh! Oh! There was a guy coming in at him. Yo, I gotta stop. I gotta stop. Alright, you know what? He's breathing heavily too, so that's... Either he's a good actor... You know what I mean? He's breathing heavily.
In an absolutely bizarre twist, what looks like a terrifying clone of himself charges toward Abiud, scaring him so much that he stumbles to the ground. When he gets back up, there's nothing there.
My God.
A strange symbol that wasn't there before now appears on the mirror. When Abiud checks out the living room, something dark seems to be standing there with him, visible in the reflection in the living room mirror. After this horrifying experience, Abiud takes his dog Milo on a long trip to just get away for a while. So, is Abiud Hernandez Alvarez really violently haunted?
Yeah, this got me, bro.
Bizarre horror
this got
ARG?
Me.
Either way,
honestly,
the videos are terrifying, and as all.
Yeah, it is, either this is a very well-made fake, and he's a good actor, or I.
Over on his Facebook page.
I don't know, man. It's probably crackhead energy, but.
Founded in 1811, the seaside city of Astoria, Oregon, has seen its fair share of dark history. In the early 1920s, most of the city tragically burnt to the ground. It was rebuilt with concrete-reinforced pylons, creating a creepy, hidden underground tunnel system. Many of these tunnels served as underground living space for the very poor, but they were also home to a lot of violent criminal activity and were very unsafe. One of the unfortunate poor people who lived in the tunnels was a woman named Abigail. Abigail was a poorly paid seamstress in a tailor shop during the day, and at night, she lived a very hard life down in the dark tunnels beneath the shop. In 1972, Abigail saw no way out and ended it all. Her remains weren't found until a week after her passing. Another unfortunate soul that is said to inhabit the tunnels is allegedly that of a young girl named Sarah, who is also said to have met her untimely death beneath the tailor shop. Over time, the underground tunnels were closed due to safety hazards. The tailor shop was sold and eventually became the Gully's Butcher Shop. Owner Diana Gully says that she has always had a bad feeling that someone or something might still be down in the tunnels beneath her store. Guests have taken photos in the basement of a mysterious entity that seems to be sitting in a chair. Others have gotten nasty headaches during their visits, and some have even seen a large shadow figure. The story goes that one man visiting sat down in a chair but soon fell over and then quickly ran out.
A normal human wouldn't go,
to be the spirit of little Sarah came walking towards him and pushed him right out of the chair. Diana Gully has invited popular ghost hunters Ryan, River, Wyatt, and Skylar from the YouTube channel Twin Paranormal to investigate whether the stories are true and just
who or what
might be haunting the Gully's Butcher Shop. As Ryan is interviewing Diana about her store, River is busy setting up a static camera in the tunnels. He captures something downright chilling.
So when you're checking things, maybe you could get a little bit more information about that.
See, some things may
hear differently.
Mm-hmm.
These will do some investigations. Sometimes they'll trick you.
What the f***?
You were saying that somebody was sitting there.
Right.
Could have gotten scratched on their face.
Mm-hmm.
Or could have just...
Ryan.
Yeah.
A little bit too excitement and them doing it themselves.
I don't know if I don't even want to look at this. Running footsteps. A normal person would not go there.
What happened to you?
Dude, I've never had this happen, ever. I was getting a shot, and I hear someone walking like this.
Okay.
And it came right behind my ear, and they're breathing really heavy.
No.
I've never had this happen. I almost just freaking lost it.
You okay?
I'm okay, but that was really scary.
Is that you running over here?
Yeah, it was me running over here. I've never had that happen.
If your content is primarily...
The team finishes their interview with store owner Diana and officially begins their investigation. Using a rim pod and two...
If your content is primarily about, like, ghost busting, it's very hard to kind of trust you, right? Because you might be doing that for YouTube, obviously. And there's nothing wrong with that, right? Like, if you... Because even I'm enjoying these videos, right? But it's super hard to believe you when that's your profession and you always, like, bust ghosts and you want to put videos out. Yeah, you know what I mean, right?
EMF meters, they begin to ask questions to the spirit of Abigail. And things just get weirder.
That just went to red. That just went to red.
Are you filming it?
That went all the way to red.
Yes.
Can you spike this one as well? This one in my hand?
What Please. Does that do?
Whoa.
It captures some sort of energy. I'm not really familiar with them. But heard about them, obviously,
you,
and now we're seeing it.
If this is you...
Not one, not two, but all of their devices spike at the same time. The team moves on to a different section of the basement, and their devices are still continuously spiking. That's when Ryan experiences something terrifying.
Oh, okay. Thanks for the
this
warning, though.
This just keeps going off! Thank you! Riff.
What?
Uh-oh.
Somebody's right here.
I think they're gonna throw a Twinkie or something.
Are you over here with us?
What?
I just got what you got.
Somebody's right here.
Are you over here with us? Riff.
Oh, snap.
What?
I just got what you got.
Something just took a deep, deep breath right by my ear. If I had a heart monitor right now, my heart is beating so fast.
Just like his brother River, Ryan experiences and hears the breath of someone right next to his ear. But that's not all that the Twin Paranormal guys catch at Gully's Butcher Shop.
Here's another object here in Skylar's hand. All you have to do is walk up to this object and you hold on to this antenna or get close to this metal rod that you see and it'll light up and it'll make noise. I'm going to go ahead and set it over here in this walkway if you can come over to us and use
Dude,
your
Dude, why would you go down,
Give us
you know?
A sign that you are here with that.
There's just a lot of crackheads and I have a feeling that some... Yeah, I was gonna say before too. I was literally gonna say, but I was like, I'm gonna wait till they
Give
finish talking.
Give us a sign that you are here with that.
Nah, cameras,
the
would they really capture them?
Seemingly walking around down in the tunnels is captured on camera.
That's definitely a human. No, that's definitely a human
just
playing
recorded,
around.
But they do hear footsteps coming from that direction. So could this be the spirit of Abigail? Could it be the ghost of little Sarah? Or
where is Scooby-Doo
worse?
When you need him?
Let me know what you
to
think.
To hunt them
the
down.
The legend of Kashima Reiko.
Oh,
so the story
oh,
with this next video
this
goes
Japanese?
That an anonymous Japanese man lost a bet with his friends, and so they dared him to explore an allegedly haunted forest completely alone.
Is that
as
the Logan Paul one?
The
Where Logan Paul
experience.
Went?
He hikes into the woods just as the sun goes down. As you might suspect, it did not go well.
Dude, okay, listen. Japan, ghost, forest, sun going down. Run! That's not good. Sun going down. Nah, I don't like this. Yeah. Probably crackhead energy, but... probably, yeah, probably a Japanese. Konnichiwa, umai wa mu, shinde. This is giving me a bad feeling. It is giving me a bad feeling too, Doug. You should not be here. This is low IQ decisions. Why? What should I do? Just go home. Just leave the area. Because it's probably a crackhead somewhere. It's getting dark. My god, it's not getting dark. It is dark. What do you mean? 5:01 p.m. right now. Uh-oh. Yeah, I don't know. I feel like somebody's behind the tree. This is bad. It's 5:10 p.m. Okay, now it's dark. It's not really dark. It's just dark. It's just dark. We cannot even see anything. Yeah, I feel like something is just gonna pop. Oh, snap. Is that like a Call of Duty Zombies crawler? No, I guess crawler? I played Call of Duty Zombies in my early days. So it kind of looks... Remind me of that creature. It might be a chihuahua or something, you know? Might be a chihuahua. Somebody's chihuahua. It might be... You never know, a bird, maybe? You know what I mean? Oh, daddy. Yeah, run, brother. Just run, man.
The pale, disembodied torso of a woman appears to crawl her way out of the forest, getting closer and closer. The man makes a run for it, and the video abruptly ends. Now, Japanese viewers say that the mysterious video has a basis in the frightening urban legend of Kashima Reiko. The story says that the vengeful spirit of a woman is forever looking for her lost legs. And if she happens upon someone, she will take the legs of anyone she encounters.
Yeah, okay, noted. Never go there. Ladies and gentlemen, that's enough. Make sure to check out part 2 and 1, and I'll see you there. But click on this video on the screen, and I will see you right there. Just click it, man. You're gonna...